So a person should realize that the Sahabas were praised by Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And we were only given the option to follow them. We have no other option. That's the option that is open for us, is to follow them. And if we don't follow them, then we have no good in us. As Allah said in subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there's no guidance for us if we don't follow them. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ. Allah talked about the muhajirin and the ansar. You have to ask yourself, are you a muhajir? The answer is no. Are you a ansari? The answer is no. Then be from the third one. وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ. I don't remember exactly who it was. A man from the innovators came to a imam. And he said to him, when he criticized one of the sahabas. And he said to him, are you from the muhajirin? The man said, no. He said, are you from the Ansar? And he said, no. And he said, I witness you're not from the people who follow them in good. وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ. I witness that you're not from the third one as well. That's yours. You choose. Are you from the muhajirin? Are you from the Ansar? None of us are. So who are we? وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ. Those who follow them in what? بِإِحْسَانٍ, in good. رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُمْ. Allah is pleased with us. We only get radiyallahu anhu when? Radiyallahu anhu, when do we get it? Why didn't Allah say وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ بِإِحْسَانٍ about the muhajirin and the ansar? Go to tafsir al-Qurtubi and you see why. They don't deserve. They're all righteous. They're all what? Righteous. Radiyallahu anhum. Allah is pleased with them. وَرَضُوا عَنْهُ. And they are pleased with Allah. وَعَدَّ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي تَحْتَهَا الْأَنْهَارِ خالدين فيها أبدا ذلك الفوز العظيم. Good. نعم. So leave the Sahabas of the Prophet alone, and don't be one who, wallahi, the Day of Judgment, the person you're against and that you have to speak against or you have to argue with, be the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Then the Sheikh said, وَمُوَدَّةُ الْقُرْبَى بِهَا أَتَوَصَّلُ. وَمُوَدَّةُ الْقُرْبَى is who? Is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's family. Qurba is who? Is the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his family. Alayhi salatu wa salam. We have to love the family of who? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have to love the family of who? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The qaraba, the Prophet's family, who fall under it. Who is from the qaraba of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? The qaraba of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his wives fall under it. Ala ragmi anfi. Ala ragmi anfi ha'ula. What's the evidence for that? If you look at Surah Al-Ahzab, where Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he speaks about the wives of the Prophet in the siyaq. Ya nisa al-Nabi, man ya'ti min kunna bi fahishati mubayyina, yudha'af laha al-adhabu du'ufayn, wa kana dhalika ala Allah yasira. Ya nisa al-Nabi, لستن كأحد من النساء إن اتقيتن فلا تخطعن بالقول فيطمع الذي في قلبه مرض وقلن قولا معروفا وقرن في بيوتكن ولا تبرجن تبرج الجاهلية الأولى وأقمن الصلاة وآتين الزكاة وأطعن الله ورسوله إنما يريد الله ليذهب عنكم الرجز أهل البيت ويطهركم تطهيرا. In what context did Allah say أهل البيت؟ أهل, family of the Prophet. What context? After talking to the wives of the Prophet. The khitab, the addressing was directed at who? The wives of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they fall under it. Aisha is from the wives of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And she's from the family of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, وَمُوَدَّةُ, and she falls as a companion, female companion. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the ayah Allah says, قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا إِلَّا الْمُوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah said to him, say, I don't ask you, قُلْ لَا أَسْأَلُكُمْ عَلَيْهِ أَجْرًا. I don't ask you guys for reward. I don't want finance and money from you guys. I only ask one thing from you guys. إِلَّا الْمُوَدَّةَ فِي الْقُرْبَى. To keep ties, kinship, look after my family. So the Prophet's family we love. وَنَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَى اللَّهِ بِحُبِّهِمْ. And we get closer to Allah by loving Hassan and Hussein. We also believe that the family of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not only Hassan and Hussein. And the children, and Ali ibn Abi Talib only. We believe what? We believe Uthman is from the Ahlul Bayt. We believe who? Abbas ibn Abd al-Muttalib is from Ahlul Bayt. Do they believe that Abbas ibn Abd al-Muttalib, Abdullah ibn Abbas is from Ahlul Bayt? No, they don't. They don't believe it. We believe that. We believe he's from Ahlul Bayt. Pay attention. Focus here. نعم ومودة القربى and the loving of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم بها أتوسل I get closer to Allah. This is the type of tawassul that's permissible. The tawassul, it's permissible with its conditions that it has to meet. And we have spoken that in details in our current explanation of the book تطهير الاعتقاد of Muhammad Amir al-San'ani. We spoke about it there مفصلا in more details than here. Then the author says, وَلِكُلِّهِمْ قَدْرٌ Each and every one of them, what does he have? So the Sahabas, we love them what? We love them. وَلِكُلِّهِمْ قَدْرٌ عَلَى وَفَضَائِلٌ All of them, what do they have? They have a status. So meaning the Sahabas are not all of one level. وَلِكُلِّهِمْ قَدْرٌ عَلَى وَفَضَائِلٌ All of them, they have different levels and statuses. The Sahabas are not all of one level. They're all different levels. لَكِنَّمَا الصِّدِّيقُ مِنْهُمْ أَفْضَلُ Abu Bakr is the best one. Who's the best person? The best one of them is who? Abu Bakr. And this is the belief of Ahlul Sunnah. This is the belief of who? Ahlul Sunnah. Abu Bakr is the best. رضي الله تعالى عنهم. After him is who? Umar al-Faruq, Umar ibn al-Khattab. And then after that is who? Uthman Dhu al-Nurayn. And then after that is who? Ali ibn Abi Talib, Abu al-Sibtayn. So Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, Umar al-Faruq. The first one is who? Abu Bakr al-Siddiq is the first one. Umar al-Faruq. The third one is who? Uthman ibn Affan, Dhu al-Nurayn. And the fourth one is who? Ali ibn Abi Talib, Abu al-Sibtayn. The father of Hassan and Hussein. That's how it is. And then after that, who comes? Baqi al-Sitta, the six remaining Ahlul Jannah. The six remaining from the people of Ahlul Jannah, Zubayr ibn Awam, Talha ibn Ubaidillah, Sa'ad ibn Abi Waqas, AbdulRahman ibn Auf, Sa'ad ibn Zayd, Abu Ubaidah, Amir ibn Jarrah. That's how it goes. And this is freeing us ourselves from those deviated groups who have opened their tongues in doing takfir on the Sahabas. The haqq is what? أن نتولاهم جميعا. That we love all of them. ونحبهم وننزلهم منازلهم التي أنزلهم الله. We love them. We take them as our allies. And we get closer to Allah by loving them. And we place them in the places which Allah تبارك وتعالى placed them in. So we don't believe all of them are the same. Who is the best of them? Abu Bakr. Because of the extensive evidences that came to prove Abu Bakr's status is above all of them. The Prophet said, لو كنت متخذا من أهل الأرض خليلا لاتخذت أبا بكر خليلا. If I was to ever take a very, 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 very close friend from the people of this earth, who would have I taken? Who would I have taken? I would have taken Abu Bakr رضي الله تعالى عنه. I would have taken who? Abu Bakr. So he has that status above all. And the other second evidence that shows Abu Bakr is the best is because Abu Bakr, the ijma', the unanimous agreement of the Sahabas that they put him forward. They put him forward. Over all the other Sahabas. When they were at the place of Bani Saqifa, and they asked Abu Bakr, ibsut yadaka, Umar said to him, open your hand. Fabayyuhu, they gave him the Pledge of Allegiance. That ijma' of the Sahabas is an indication to show, and not one of them opposed them. Huh? At that moment, Sa'd ibn Ubad was said that he opposed, but after that he agreed. The ijma' of the Sahaba qatibatan unanimously on Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, because he was the most virtuous individual of their time. Those two evidence. The evidence from the Prophet and the consensus of the Sahabas. Very good. And then Umar, because of the evidences and the consensus of the Sahabas after him. Uthman and the consensus of the Sahabas. And Ali ibn Abi Talib, رضي الله تعالى عنه. So now the first point the Shaykh spoke about which matter of the five? The Sahabas. And how we are towards the companions. فتنبه, be aware of this issue. And we spoke about the sects that went against Ahlul Sunnah in this issue. Then the Shaykh now is going to go into the next point, which is an issue pertaining to what? The names of Allah and His attributes. Pertaining to what? From the five, which one does it fall under? مسائل الأسماء والصفات. On the second point right now, realize, this book is going to talk about these 5 points. You have to realize. مسائل الأسماء والصفات. Matters pertaining to what? Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala's names and attributes. As a person of Sunnah, inshallah ta'ala, which you all are, you have to learn this automatically. Memorize this qa'ida, you have to memorize it. What is the qa'ida that you have to memorize? Allah's names are what? And what are Allah's characteristics? Allah's names are A'lamun bi'atibari dalalati ala al-dhat wa awsafun bi'atibari dalalati ala al-ma'ani. Allah's names are not mujarrad a'lam. Allah's names are not mere names that don't have no meanings or characteristics in it. Nope. Ar-Rahman, sifatul Rahman. You see that? Al-Ghafur, sifatul Ghufran. Every name of Allah, there is a characteristics in it. So Allah and His name, subhanahu wa ta'ala, are names that we take characteristics from them. How does every name show you the characteristics of the three types? Pay attention. Every name of Allah, pay attention, has a characteristics you take from it. Allah's names are what? أَعْلَامٌ بِاعْتِبَارِ دَلَالَتِ عَلَى الذَّاتِ وَأَوْصَافٌ بِاعْتِبَارِ دَلَالَتِ عَلَى الْمَعَانِ. Allah's names indicate each name, there are characteristics that you take from it that the other name doesn't have. Ar-Rahman has a characteristics in it that Al-Ghafur doesn't have. Sifat. Each character, each name has a characteristics in it that the other one doesn't hold. Sahih? Very good. So, the Mu'tazila said, that can't be right. That can't be right. They oppose that qa'ida that we mentioned. They're Mu'tazila are who? I spoke about them before. Their head and their leader was who? Wasil ibn Ata', who was one of the students of Hassan al-Basri, who Hassan al-Basri said to him, I'tazil anna, get out of our gathering, move, leave us. And he got that name stuck to him, which was what? Mu'tazila. You see? The Mu'tazila opposed. They said, how many names of Allah do we have now? We know of Allah's names, 99 that we have. Are these only 99 names of Allah? No. Allah has other names that we don't know of. Because the Prophet ﷺ, he said, أَسْأَلُكَ بِكُلِّ اسْمٍ هُوَ لَكَ سَمَّيْتَ بِهِ نَفْسَكَ أَوْ أَنْزَلْتَهُ فِي كِتَابِكَ أَوْ عَلَّمْتُ أَحَدًا مِنْ خَلْقِكَ أَوْ إِسْتَأْثَرْتَ بِهِ فِي عِلْمِ الْغَيْبِ عِنْدَكَ. So there's names which Allah kept and He didn't tell us about it. They said that if we affirm that each name of Allah has a characteristics in it, then it would automatically mean that we'd have to affirm that there's more than one God. Shubha that they brought forward. Ahlul Sunnah replied to them and said, that's a lie and that is jahlun, ignorance, minkum, from you guys. They said, وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَىٰ. Allah has a higher example and exalted, but we'll prove it for you guys in the human being. A person has what in him? More than one characteristics. A person can be chubby, tall, black. All these are characteristics that are in one person. Does that mean I've spoken about three different people? He's what? He's chubby. He's tall. And he's black. These are three characteristics that are present in him. They are what? Three characteristics that are present in him. Am I speaking about three different individuals? La. إِذَنْ وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَىٰ. Allah has a higher example. To compare him, we're not trying to compare him with the creation. But we're trying to. وَبِالْمِثَالِ يَتَضِحُ الْمَقَالِ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all these are characteristics that He has. So how does each name show us that characteristics? And we've spoken about this previously in other sits, but we're going a bit detailed in this book, inshallah ta'ala, more than the previous books. دَلَالَةُ الْمُطَابَقُ دَلَالَةُ التَّضَمُّنْ and دَلَالَةُ الْإِلْتِزَامُ. Those are the three ways that the names show us the characteristics. دَلَالَةُ الْمُطَابَقُ دَلَالَةُ التَّضَمُّنْ دَلَالَةُ الْإِلْتِزَامُ. What does that mean? It basically means Dalalatul Mutabak. Let me explain each one for you, inshallah ta'ala, so you can understand it. I'll give you guys an example so it can become easy for you to understand. Take a house as an example. Bait. If I say to you now, a house, or in Arabic, if I say to you, Baytun, house. The house has locks, doors, windows, roof. All of that, it comes with the saying of the word what? House. When I said house, you thought of the doors, you thought of the windows, you thought of everything. Because that is called dalalatul mutabak. All of that which is in the house, automatically, when I say the word house, it encompasses all of that. It's called dalalatul mutabak. Dalalatul mutadammun means what? When I take a part of it. I take a part of the house. For example, I take that door. I've taken a part of the house. This is called dalalatul tadammun. Taking that which the house consists of, a portion of it. And the last one is what? Dalalatul iltizam. Dalalatul iltizam is to say, if this house has doors, has knobs, has handles to open the door, windows, roof, then a person must have made it. Dalalatul iltizam. Yastalzimu min dhalika. What necessitates from that is what? Somebody must have made it. Crystal clear? Crystal? Crystal clear. Allah's name is all of that three apply. Allah's name? Apply. Let's take the word Al-Khaliq. Allah is what? Khaliq. Isn't that his name? Let's apply those three points that we mentioned. Dalalatul mutabak, dalalatul iltizam, and dalalatul al-tadammun. Allah's name right now, Al-Khaliq. The name of Allah, Al-Khaliq. Does it show us the existence of Allah? Yes. For him to be Khaliq, the word Khaliq, what falls under it, just the same way that the house, when I said it, a window, a door, a lock, when I said Al-Khaliq, the creator, it showed me a that, something that exists. That's first. So it's, are you with me? And it also shows with it, that comes with it, which is what? That sif al-khalq, creating, that characteristics comes with it. Are you with me? So there's a that in it, and there's also an action or a characteristics and attribute in it. Are you with me? The house, the doors, and the windows. Now if I take, are you with me? If I take now the characteristics of creating, which is khalq, that's called dalalatu al-tadammun. Dalalatu al-tadammun. So the khalq, khaliq is dalalatu al-mutabak. Khaliq is dalalatu al-mutabak. It's like saying house. Are you with me? Taking a portion of it, which is Allah is that, and Allah tabaraka ta'ala is what? Khalq, he creates. Sifatul khalq. It's called dalalatu al-tadammun. Are you with me? It's called dalalatu al-tadammun. Dalalatu al-iltizam means, if Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he's a creator, this characteristics has shown me other two characteristics that I have to affirm for him. What is it? That he has knowledge and he has ability. He can't create. Just the same way that this house can't be there without somebody having made it. Somebody had to make it, right? Allah can't be a khaliq unless he is what? Unless he is alimun qadir. And every characteristics of Allah is like that. It has dalalatu al-mutabak, dalalatu al-tadammun, and dalalatu al-iltizam. And there's an evidence for that in the Quran. The last ayah in Surah Al-Talaq. Allahu alladhi khalaqa sab'a samawati wa min al-ardi mithlahunna yatanazzalu al-amru baynahunna li ta'lamu anna allaha ala kulli shay'in qadir wa anna allaha qad ahata bi kulli shay'in ilma. The beginning, what did Allah say? Allahu alladhi khalaqa sab'a samawati. Allah creates seven heavens. وَمِنَ الْأَرْضِ مِثْلَهُنَّ يَتَنَزَّلُ الْأَمْرُ بَيْنَهُنَّ لِتَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. See? وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَحَاطَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عِلْمًا. That's how Allah's characteristics works. سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. That's just one qa'idah. From the qawa'id, Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah mentioned in his book, Haqidatul Hamawiyyah, Al-Tadmuriyyah, Minhaj Sunnah Nabawiyyah, Mujmal Al-Atiqad Ahli Sunnah, qawa'id. That's just a qa'idah. Qa'idah. And that saves you a lot. Allah's characteristics are divided into two now. Allah's characteristics are divided into how much? Two. Sifat, which are called sifat datiyah, and sifat, which are called sifat fi'liyah. Sifat, which are called what? Sifat, which are called sifat datiyah. Characteristics, which are, they are always attached and connected to Allah. They never detach and they never disconnect from Allah. Such as what? Allah always hears. Allah always knows. Nah. These are sifat, which are called sifat datiyah. لا ينفكوا عن ذاته سبحانه وتعالى. They never detach from Allah تبارك وتعالى. The second one is called what? صفات فعلية. They are not attached to Allah's that, but it's connected to Allah's will. Pay attention. It is connected to Allah's will. Allah does it whenever He wills. He does it when? He does it whenever He wills. Such as what? Allah coming down and Allah تبارك وتعالى Allah coming down. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala coming down. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is sifa fi'liyah. It's a characteristics which is what? It's an action and Allah does it whenever He wishes. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Matasha. The Shaykh, he now is talking about the belief of the Quran. The Quran, which of the two does it fall under? Ahlul Sunnah have mentioned that the characteristics of speech, sifatul kalam, speech in which Ahlul Sunnah affirm for Allah, Ahlul Sunnah affirm for Allah, this characteristics is what? It's sifa dhatiyya and it's sifa fi'liyya. And why do we say that? If we say that the characteristics of speech is only sifa dhatiyya, then the question is, how do we have this Quran? If the Quran is within Allah, like knowledge is within Allah, and we don't say it's an action which Allah does, then how on earth did we get this Quran? And this is when Asha'ira affirm Allah, the speech for Allah. Because from the seven they affirm Asha'ira, from one of them is speech. Sifatul Kalam, they say we affirm it for Allah. But don't get fooled. They don't affirm it how Ahlul Sunnah affirm it. They only affirm it as what? Sifa dhatiyya. They don't believe speech comes out of Allah. They don't believe that. They believe it's like knowledge and it's within Allah and it doesn't come out of Him. So if speech doesn't come out of Allah, then how did we end up with this Quran? How did we get this Quran? Their reply to this is what? عِبَارَةٌ عَنْ كَلَامِ اللَّهِ. That this Quran is an explanation in that which was within Allah. So the question is, who explained it? Who brought it out? Who interpreted it? They argued amongst themselves of two views. Some said Jibreel and some said Nabiullah Muhammad. So this Quran that we have, the wording is not Allah. Whose wording is it? Jibreel or Nabiullah Muhammad? See how filthy that view is. وَمَا هُوَ بِقَوْلِي وَمَا هُوَ بِقَوْلِي شَاعِر. This Quran is not the speech of a person. The speech is what? It's not the poetry of the Prophet. It's not his speech. Huh? إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا قَوْلُ بَشَر سَأُسْلِيهِ سَقَر. This Quran is not قَوْلُ بَشَر. So the other Sha'ira said, oh, it can't be the speech of a Bashar, a human being. It has to be Jibreel. Within themselves. Ahlul Sunnah, what they said was, Allah speaks and Allah has a characteristics which they refer to as, Allah has a sound. Sawt. Which we can hear. It's a characteristics. Which they affirm for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What's the, when they were asked, what's your evidence that Allah does not speak and it doesn't come out of Him? They said, a statement of a man we're going to take later his name. They said, "Inna al-kalam la fil fuadi, wa innama ju'ila al-lisan lima fil fuadi dalila." That the speech is what's in the chest. The tongue is only an evidence, but the real speech is what's within you. Ahlul Sunnah argued with them and replied to them by saying to them. Ahlul Sunnah replied by saying to them that the Quran that we have, it's within Allah. So the speech is within Allah. They said, yes. And does it come out? No, it doesn't come out. Because speech to us is what's within. Okay, good. then what was the wisdom? What was the wisdom in when Allah said about Zakariya alayhi salam? قال ربي جعل لي آية قال آيتك ألا تكلم الناس ثلاث ليال إلا رمزا. He said, oh Allah, make a sign for me. When my wife is giving birth and she's about to, when my wife becomes pregnant and then the child is forming in her stomach, I want to know. Oh Allah, give me a sign. Allah said that the sign is that you will be mute and you won't be able to speak. قال ربي جعل لي آية قال آيتك ألا تكلم الناس, that you don't speak to the people. So what has Allah negated from him? Speech, right? Kalam was negated from him. According to the Asha'ira, kalam shouldn't be negated from him, because he did speak in his heart. If it's something within, then how was what was being negated from Zakariya alayhi salam? What was being negated from Zakariya alayhi salam? Doesn't make sense. Because according to you guys, the fact that he can move his hands around is a kalam for you guys. He can still speak, is within him. So that's what happens to a person who goes against the Kitab and the Sunnah and follows their whims and desires, that's what happens to them. So Ahlul Sunnah, what do they say? That the Quran is the speech of Allah. The Quran is what? The Quran, Ahlul Sunnah believe it is Kalamullah, it's the speech of Allah. Munazzalun, it came down from him. غَيْرُ مَخْلُوقٍ, it is not created. And they have evidences regarding that, extensive evidences. That is the speech of Allah. Allah says in the Quran, وَإِنْ أَحَدٌ مِّنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ اسْتَجَارَكَ فَأَجِرْهُ حَتَّى يَسْمَعَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ, until he hears what? حَتَّى يَسْمَعَ كَلَامَ اللَّهِ, until he hears the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Until he hears the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they also mentions that أَنَّ مَنْ قَالَ, anyone who says القرآن مخلوق, anyone who says that the Quran is created, the Salaf of this Ummah, scholars from the Salaf of this Ummah, they refer to them as Kuffar. And the number of scholars who made the Jahmiyyah, who said this statement, Kuffar, was 500 scholars. They made takfir of the Jahmiyyah.